we shall solve problems on monotonic sequences. Show that the sequence AN defined by A1 is equal to square root of 2 and AN plus 1 is equal to square root of 2 into AN converges to 2. We know that yes, monotonically increasing sequence which is bounded above converges and converges to its supremum. Therefore, to show the given sequence converges to 2, the first thing is we have to show that the given sequence is monotonically increasing. The second thing is we have to show that the given sequence is bounded above by 2. Then we can conclude that the sequence converges. The third step is we have to show that the sequence converges to the limit 2. This is the process for any problem on monotonic sequences. Now, solution. First, let us prove that sequence AN is monotonically increasing. What do you mean by monotonically increasing? We say a sequence is monotonically increasing if AN plus 1 is greater than or equals to AN for all N belong to N. That is, every successive term is greater than or equal to its previous term. Let us prove it by mathematical induction. We have 11 methods of proof to prove a statement in mathematics. They are direct proof, proof by mathematical induction, proof by transposition, proof by contradiction, proof by construction, exhaustion, probabilistic proof, combinatorial proof, non-constructive proof, statistical proof of pure mathematics, and computer assisted proof. What is mathematical induction? Mathematical induction is a mathematical proof. It is essentially used to prove that a statement P of N or S of N holds for every natural number N. For every natural number N. A proof by induction consists of two cases. The first case is we have to prove it for N equals to 1. That is the base case or the basis which proves the statement for N equals to 1 without assuming any knowledge of other cases. The second case, the induction step, proves that if the statement holds for any given case N equal to K, then it must also hold for the next case N equals to K plus 1. These two steps establish that the statement holds for every natural number N. Actually, there are three steps here. The first step is we have to show that the given statement is true for N equals to 1. The statement is true for N equals to 1. The second step is we have to assume that the given statement is true for N is equals to K. The third step is we have to prove the given statement for N is equals to K plus 1. Now, let us prove this by mathematical induction. A1 is equals to root 2 and A2 is equals to square root of A1, because what is a n plus 1 is square root of 2 into a n. If you want to find a 2, now what you are doing is put n is equals to 1 here, then we get it is a suffix 2, that is equals to square root of 2 into a1, 2 into a1, that's the one we have written here, that is equals to square root of 2 into what is the value of a1? A1 value is root 2. A1 value is root 2. Therefore, that is nothing but which is greater than root 2, because square root of 2 into root 2 is greater than root 2, because root 2 is a positive value. What is root 2 value? Root 2 is a1. Thus, a2 is greater than a1. So a1 is root 2. Now we have shown that a2 is greater than a1. Let us suppose that an is greater than an minus 1. That is, the first case is over. What's the first case? It is true for n equal to 1. Now we assume that the statement is true for n minus 1. N minus 1. Now we have to prove it for a suffix n. So we want to prove it for a suffix n, and hence we have to multiply both sides by 2. Why both sides by 2? Because an plus 1 is equals to square root of 2 into an, this 2, the number 2. Therefore, let us multiply both sides by 2. Since 2 being a positive number, the inequality is preserved. There is no change in the inequality. Now, next thing is we have to take square root on both sides. Taking square root on both sides, we get this. But what is square root of 2 into an? Square root of 2 into an is an plus 1. That is, an plus 1 is greater than what is square root of 2 into an minus 1? It is an. Thus, in the first case, we have proved it for n equal to 1. Then we assumed for n minus 1. Now we have proved it for n is equals to n. That is, all the three steps of mathematical inductions are satisfied. And hence, by mathematical induction, we say that an plus 1 is greater than an for all n belong to n. Therefore, by mathematical induction, we say that the sequence an is monotonically increasing. Thus, the first part of the problem is over. Now, second part is, we have to show that the given sequence an is bounded above by this number. What's the number? 2. Whatever number is given, that is the number we'll be taking. Now, we have to show that the sequence an is bounded above by 2. That is, what is my bounded above? An is less than 2 for all n. That is, each and every term of the sequence must be less than 2. That is, a1 must be less than 2, a2 less than 2, a10 less than 2, a100 less than 2, a1 lakh less than 2, a1 crore less than 2. It must be true for every natural number. Again, we are going to use mathematical induction to prove this part. Now, what is A1? A1 is given in the statement, in the problem. A1 is equal to root 2. Clearly, which is greater? Root 2 or 2? 2 is greater than root 2. Therefore, A1 is equals to root 2, which is less than 2. Thus, n equals to 1 is satisfied. Now, we have to assume for for n. Assume that an is less than 2. This is the second step. Now what you have to do? We have to prove it for a suffix n plus 1. This is case 1 for n equal to 1, case 2 for n, case 3 for n plus 1. How do you get n plus 1? What is n plus 1? An plus 1 is equal to square root of 2 into an. Now we have an. How to get an plus 1? For that, we have to multiply both sides by 2. Both sides by 2. Therefore, it is 2 into an. 2 twos are 4. 2 twos are 4. This implies, now take square root on both sides. Therefore, square root of 2 into an is less than root 4. What is square root of 2 into an? That is nothing but an plus 1. What is root 4? 2. Therefore, this an plus 1 is less than 2. That's the three cases of mathematical inductions are satisfied. That is, we showed that it is true for n equal to 1 and we assumed for n. Now we have proved it for n minus 1. Sorry, n plus 1. Therefore, by mathematical induction, an is less than 2 for all n belong to n. Therefore, the sequence an is bounded above by 2. Thus, the sequence an is monotonically increasing and bounded above. Hence, it converges. Converges to what number? That we have to find out. So now assume that it converges to L. But what's the question? The question says the given sequence an converges to 2. Therefore, now we have to show that the value of L is 2. Now our aim is to prove that the value of L is 2. Now what is an plus 1? An plus 1 is square root of 2 into an. Now squaring on both sides to get L equal to 2. Now we have to remove the square root. To eliminate the square root, squaring on both sides, then we get an plus 1 whole square is equals to 2 into an. Now taking limit on both sides, limit of an plus 1 whole square is equals to 2 into limit of an as n tends to infinity. Now we have mentioned that, or we have taken that the sequence an converges to L. That means limit of an as n tends to infinity is L. When it is L, what about next term? Limit of an plus 1 as n tends to infinity, that is also L. Because when you say converges, it all the values are converges to only one point. Only one point. That is L. That is every term in the sequence after mth term is equals to L. Therefore, limit of an as n tends to infinity is L implies limit of an plus 1 as n tends to infinity is also L. Therefore, the next step will be, this is L and hence it becomes L square is equals to 2 into its value is L. That is, L square is equals to 2 into L. Now we have to find the value of L. So bring this 2L to left hand side. So L square minus 2L is 0. Take L common here. We take L common, we have L into L minus 2 equal to 0. That means either L equal to 0 or L minus 2 equal to 0. But we have to show that L equal to 2. That is, we have to eliminate L equal to 0. How to eliminate L equal to 0? How to eliminate? If you look at the problem, in the problem we are given A1 is equal to root 2. A1 is root 2. What is A2? 2 into square root of 2 into root 2. What is An plus 1? Square root of 2 into An plus 1. That is, each and every term of the sequence is positive. It is more than 0. And hence, L cannot be 0. That is, every term is more than 0, greater than 0. And hence, L cannot be 0. L cannot be 0. So, the only possibility is L is equals to 2. Thus, the sequence An is monotonically increasing and the bounded above by 2. Hence, it converges to 2. That is, the given sequence An converges to 2. The next question. Show that the sequence An defined by A1 is equal to square root of 7 and An plus 1 is equal to square root of 7 plus An. If you recall question number 1, the question number 1 was A1 is root 2. What is An plus 1? An plus 1 is square root of 2 into An. There is a multiplication, but here it is addition. Here it is addition. There is a multiplication. There's a product. Here is a sum. That's the only difference. Otherwise, the steps are the same steps. Now we have to show that the sequence An converges to the positive root of the equation x squared minus x minus 7 equal to 0. Why is a positive root? Why is a positive root? Why can't negative root? Because what is A1 value? A1 is root 7. Root 7 is more than 0. It is positive. What is An plus 2? An plus 2 will be square root of 7 plus A1. What is A1? Root 7. That is square root of 7 plus root 7, which is also more than 0. That is, each and every term of the given sequence is positive. Therefore, the given sequence converges to positive root of the equation, namely x squared minus x minus 7 equal to 0. First, let us prove that sequence An is monotonically increasing. What is monotonically increasing? That is to prove that An plus 1 is greater than or equal to An for all n belong to n. Let us prove it by mathematical induction. Again, we recall the induction. It consists of 3 steps. The first step is we have to show that the given statement is true for n equals to 1. Then we'll be assuming for n or n minus 1. Then we will prove it for n plus 1 or n. Let us take what is given. We are given A1 equal to root 7 and An plus 1 equals to square root of 7 plus An. Now we have to show that the given statement is true for n equal to 1. That is, we have to show that A2 is greater than A1. A2 is greater than A1. So A1 value is known to us. What is A2? How to find A2? To find A2, put n equals to 1 here. Then it becomes A2 is equal to square root of 7 plus A1. Since we know the value of A1, we can substitute here. Now, put n equal to 1 in this equation. We will get A2 is equals to square root of 7 plus A1. What is A1? Square root of 7. So that is equal to square root of 7 plus A1. This A1 is root 7. Root 7. Clearly, square root of 7 plus root 7 is greater than root 7 because root 7 value is positive. Therefore, root 7 plus some positive value is greater than root 7. What is root 7? A1. Thus, A2 is just greater than A1. Therefore, A2 is greater than A1. That's the first case is over. But second case, we assume that the statement is true for n minus 1. Statement is true for n minus 1. That is, an is greater than an minus 1. Now we have to prove it for n. That is, we have to show that an plus 1 is greater than an. How do you get an plus 1? An plus 1 is square root of 7 plus an. We have only an. To get an plus 1, what we do? First, we have to add 7. Then we take square root. And hence, the next step is to adding 7 on both sides. The next one is taking square root on both sides. Yes, we have done it. What is its value? Square root of 7 plus an is an plus 1. Then what would be the value of square root of 7 plus an minus 1? This will be the value of an. Thus, we assumed that the statement is true for n minus 1. Now, we have proved that the statement is true for n. Thus, we have proved the given statement is true for n equal to 1. We have assumed for n minus 1. Now, we have proved it for n. Therefore, by mathematical induction, what you can see? The given statement is true for every term. It's true for every term. That is, an plus 1 is greater than an for all n belong to n. That is, we say that the sequence an is monotonically increasing. So, the first case of this problem is over. What's the second case? The first case is the sequence an is monotonically increasing. For second case, we have to show that the sequence an is bounded above. Bounded above by which number? This is the number. Whatever number is given in the question. That is the number. So now we will prove that the given sequence is bounded above by 7. That is, an is less than 7 for all n. That is, a1 is less than 7, a2 less than 7, a3 is less than 7, a10 is less than 7, a101 is less than 7, a3000 is less than 1, and hence it goes for every number. How we are going to prove it? Again, we have to seek the tool which is available in mathematics. That is the mathematical induction. So, we will going to prove it for n equal to 1. Then, the rest of the cases. Now, what is a1? a1 is root 7. Clearly, which is greater? Root 7 or 7? 7 is greater than root 7. Therefore, we can write this is less than 7. Or we can say that this A1 is less than 7. A1 is less than 7. Case 1 is over. Now, assume for n. We assume that the sequence is true for n. That is, up to n. Suppose n is 100. It is true up to 100 only, A100 only. What about A101? That you have to prove. So now assume that the given statement is true for n. That is, an is less than 7. Now we have to prove it for n plus 1. That is, we have to show that an plus 1 is less than 7. Now we have to show that the third case of mathematical induction is an plus 1 is less than 7. How do you get an plus 1 plus an? an. We know that an plus 1 is square root of 7 plus an. 7 plus an. Therefore, now what you have to do? Adding 7 on both sides. 7 on both sides. But what is an plus 1? It is square root of 7 plus an. Therefore, taking square root on both sides. This is square root of 7 plus an less than root 14. What is this value? What is this value? Square root of 7 plus an. That is nothing but an plus 1 less than root 14. Now, which is greater, 7 or root 14? What is the approximate value of root 14? We know square root of 9 is 3. Square root of 16 is 4. Therefore, the square root of 14 value will be between 3 and 4. It may be 3 point some value. 3 point some value. So, root 14 value is 3 point something. Clearly, 7 is greater than 3 point something. Therefore, which is less than 7. That is, an plus 1 is less than 7. Less than 7. Thus, the three cases, namely, we have proved the theorem, the result or the given problem for n equals to 1. We assumed for n. We have proved it for n plus 1. Therefore, by mathematical induction, it is true for every n. That is, an is less than 7 for all n belong to n. That is, every term of the sequence is less than 7. That is, sequence an is bounded above by 7. What is equation number 1? Number 1 is sequence an is monotonically increasing. What is 2 now? It is bounded above by 7. And hence by the result, the sequence an which is monotonically increasing and bounded above must converge. Must converge. Therefore, you can say from 1 and 2 we have the sequence an converges to some number. What number? We call it as L. Now, the third part is to find the value of L. We are going to find the value of L. That's the third part. That is, we are going to find, or we are going to show that L is the positive root of the equation x squared minus x minus 7 equals to 0. This is the third part of the problem. Now, what is an plus 1? See, remember that for the third part, to find the limit of the given sequence, we always start with an plus 1. We always start the thing from an plus 1. Now, what is an plus 1? That is equals to square root of 7 plus an. Now, what's the next step? The next step is to eliminate the square root symbol, the radical symbol. For that, we have to squaring on both sides. So, squaring on both sides, then we get an plus 1 whole squared is equal to square root of 7 plus an whole squared. That implies square and the square root get cancelled. Hence, we have an plus 1 whole squared is equal to 7 plus an. What the next step? What next step? Next step is taking limit. Because what is L? L is the limit of the given sequence. That is the positive root of the equation. So, to get the L value, taking limit on both sides. So, limit of an plus 1 whole squared as n tends to infinity is 7 plus limit of an as n tends to infinity, because 7 is a constant. There is no n here. And hence, we need not apply limit for 7. So, we can write directly 7. And we have already assumed that the sequence an converges to L. That is, limit of an as n tends to infinity is L. Then, an converges to L. What about an plus 1? Converges to the same limit. That is, an, limit of an as n tends to infinity is L. Then, naturally, replace n by any other value greater than n. It must be L. It must be L. Therefore, limit of an plus 1 as n tends to infinity is also L. Therefore, the next step, we are going to replace limit of an plus 1 as n tends to infinity is by L. And the limit of an as n tends to infinity is by L. Therefore, we get it is L squared equal to 7 plus L. Now, look at this. Bring everything, all the terms to the left hand side. Now, what type of equation is this? This is a quadratic equation. We have to solve for this is of the form AL squared plus BL plus C equal to 0. What is A? A is 1. What is B? Minus 1. What is C? Minus 7. So, where A is 1, B is minus 1, C is minus 7. How to get the roots of a quadratic equation? We have a formula. What's the formula? Here, L is the variable. So, we take L. L is equals to minus B plus or minus square root of B squared minus 4AC by 2A. To get the values of A, let us substitute the values of A, B, C in this expression. That is, B equals to minus 1. So, B squared minus 1 whole squared minus 4 into what is A? A is 1. What is C? Minus 7. By 2 into A, A is 1. Now, we know that minus of minus is plus. So, we get 1 here. Plus or minus. Minus 1 squared is 1. Here, minus into minus plus, 4 sevens are 28. Therefore, it is 1 plus 28 by 2. What is 1 plus 28? 29. Therefore, it is 1 plus square root of 29 by 2. This has got two values. One is plus, another is minus. So, what are the values now? L is equal to 1 plus root 29 by 2. Other value is 1 minus square root of 29 by 2. That's if we solve this equation, we will get L is equal to 1 plus root 29 by 2, or L is equals to 1 minus root 29 by 2. What about the first value? First value is positive, because root 29 is positive. 1 plus root 29 is positive. 1 plus root 29 by 2 is also positive. What about second value? What is root 29 value? We know root 25 is 5. Root 36 is 6. So, the value of root 29 is between 5 and 6. 5 and 6. That is, it is more than 5 but less than 6. Whether it is more than 5 or less than 6, 1 minus root 29 is a negative value. Therefore, negative by positive is negative. Therefore, this 1 minus root 29 by 2 is a negative value, whereas 1 plus root 29 by 3 is a positive value. How to put the value? L takes positive value or negative value. What is L? L is the limit of the sequence. What is the sequence? The sequence is A1 is equal to root 7. What is an plus 1? Square root of 7 plus an. That is, each and every term of the given sequence is positive. Therefore, L cannot take the negative value. That is, since an is greater than 0 for all n and the limit of an as n tends to infinity is 0, this L cannot be negative value. Cannot be negative value. Therefore, we can rule out the value of 1 minus root 29 by 2. This is ruled out. And hence, we have only one value, namely, what is that value? L is equal to 1 plus root 29 by 2. That's the only value. So, what is L? L is the positive root of the equation x squared minus x minus 7 equal to 0. Positive root. And hence, we say that the given sequence converges to L. What is L? L is the positive root of the equation. So, an converges to positive root of the equation x squared minus x minus 7 equal to 0. Now, we will discuss another example. Show that the sequence an defined by a1 equal to root 1. We know root 1 is 1. And an plus 1 is square root of 2 plus an. Converges to the positive root of the equation x squared minus x minus 2 equal to 0. If you recall problem number 2, what is the statement of question number 2? The sequence an defined by a1 is equals to root 7 and the an plus 1 is equal to square root of 7 plus an, and again the method is just similar to the question number 2, because plus here, question number 2. What's the difference? The only difference is here 1, here we have 2. We have 2. That's the only difference. Otherwise, everything is the same. Now, first let us prove that the sequence an is monotonically increasing. That is, we have to show that an plus 1 is greater than an for all n belong to capital N. How do you prove this? Which method are you going to use? Which method? The same method. That is mathematical induction. Let us prove it by mathematical induction. First, we have to prove it for A1. That is, we have to show that A2 is greater than A1. So, let us start with A1 here. Start with A1. A1 is square root of 1 is equals to 1. And an plus 1 is equal to square root of 2 plus an. How do you get A2? If you keep n equal to 1 here, we get A2. So, keep n equal to 1 here, this becomes a1 plus 1 is a2. That is equal to square root of 2 plus a1. What is a1 value? It is 1. Therefore, square root of 2 plus 1. What is square root of 2 plus 1? Root 3. Root 3 is greater than 1. What is 1? A1. That is, A2 is greater than A1. A2 is greater than A1. Thus, the statement is true for n is equals to 1. N is equals to 1. Now we have to assume for n minus 1 and we will prove it for n. So next step is, suppose that an is greater than an minus 1. That is, we assume that the statement is true for n minus 1. Now we have to prove it for n. That is, we have to show that an plus 1 is greater than an. How do you get an plus 1? An plus 1 is square root of 2 plus an. But we have an here. We have only an. So what shall we do? First, we have to add 2. Then we have to take square root. Therefore, adding 2 on both sides, we get 2 plus an is greater than 2 plus an minus 1. To get an plus 1, taking square root on both sides, we are taken. What is its value? Its value is nothing but an plus 1. What about its value? Nothing but an. Thus, an plus 1 is greater than an. Thus, the three steps of mathematical induction, namely, this is true for 1, that is a2 is greater than a1. Next, we assumed for n minus 1, that is an is greater than an minus 1. Next, we have proved it for an, that is an plus 1 is greater than an. And hence, we can conclude that the sequence an is monotonically increasing. That is, an plus 1 is greater than an for all n belong to n. Thus, the first case of this question is over. For the second case, we have to show that the sequence an is monotonically bounded above. It is bounded above. That is the next part. Let us now prove that the sequence an is bounded above by 2. What's the 2? That number 2 is square root of 2 plus an. That 2. That means we have to show that an is less than 2 for all n belong to n. That is, a1 is less than 2, a10 is less than 2, a1 crore is less than 2, a trillion is less than 2, you name any value for n which is less than 2. How we are going to prove it? Again, we are going to seek the help of mathematical induction. We have to prove it for n equal to 1, then assume for n, then prove it for n plus 1. What is a1? a1 is 1. Which is greater, 2 or 1? Naturally, 2 is greater than 1. Therefore, a1 is less than 2. a1 is less than 2. That is, step number 1 is over. Now, what's the next step? We have to assume for n. Suppose an is less than 2. Now, what do you have to say? What do you have to prove? We have to prove that an plus 1 is less than 2. How do you get an plus 1? It is very easy. Since we have an, to get an plus 1, what do you have to do? We have to add 2 first, then we have to take square root. Therefore, the next step is adding 2 on both sides. Yes, we have added 2 on both sides to become. This becomes an plus 1. What you have to do? We need square root. Therefore, taking square root on both sides, it is square root of 2 plus an, which is less than 2 plus 3 is 4. We know root 4 is 2. But what is this value? This is nothing but an plus 1. So, an plus 1 is less than 2. Thus, the three cases, what is that? N equal to 1. N plus 1, all the three cases are proved. That is, we have proved that the statement is true for n equal to 1, and we assumed that the statement is true for n, and now we have proved that the statement is true for n plus 1, and hence by mathematical induction, it is true for any term of the sequence, that is, an is less than 2 for all n belong to natural number. Thus, an, the sequence an, is bounded above by 2. What is equation number 1? Sequence an is monotonically increasing. What is 2 says? Sequence an is bounded above by 2. And hence, by a result, this sequence an, which is monotonically increasing and bounded above, must converge. Therefore, from 1 and 2, we have sequence an converges to, let us call it as L. What is L? That is the one we have to do it. That's the third part of this question. Now we have to show that this L is nothing but positive square root of x squared minus x minus 2 equals to 0. That's the third part. L is the positive root of the equation x squared minus x minus 2 equals to 0. How to start with? How to start with? To find the value of L, we have to start with an plus 1. So an plus 1 is equal to square root of 2 plus an. What is the next step? We have to eliminate this radical symbol. That is the square root symbol. To eliminate the square root symbol, what you have to do? Squaring on both sides. Squaring on both sides. So next step, what is that? Square root and square get cancelled, and hence we get an plus 1 whole squared is equals to 2 plus an. How do you get L from this? How do you get L from this? What is L? The sequence converges to L. That is limit of an as n tends to infinity is L. We have an here. How do you get L? How do you get L? To get L, we have to apply limit on both sides. Applying limit on both sides. Since 2 being a constant, we need not apply limit for this. Even if you apply limit for this, what happens? We get the constant, namely 2. Therefore, 2. And we know that limit of an as n tends to infinity is L. Therefore, what about an plus 1? It is also L. It is also L. Because by the definition of convergence after mth term, from mth term onwards, or from mth term and after every term, the sequence will have the same value. Will have the same value. Since limit of an as n tends to infinity is L, limit of an plus 1 as n tends to infinity also must take the value L. Must take the value L. Therefore, now what happened? This becomes L squared equals to 2 plus L. L squared equal to 2 plus L. Now, bring these two terms to the left hand side. Then we get L squared minus L minus 2 equal to 0. This is also a quadratic equation. We are going to solve this. It's a very simple equation. Now, to solve this, we can simply add L and subtract L so that it becomes L squared minus 2L plus L minus 2. The value will not change. When you add and subtract the same element or number in an equation, it will not affect the equality sign. Thus, L squared minus 2L plus L minus 2 equal to 0. What shall we do next? Here, if we consider the first two terms, what is common? L is common. So, take L out from the first two terms. When you take L out, what is left out? We are left with L minus 2 plus the third term, fourth term, we are writing like this, L minus 2. Now, look at this equation. What is common? It is written very clearly in blue color. L minus 2 is common. Take L minus 2 common. When you take L minus 2 common, what happened? Here we have L. Here is like 1. Here is 1. When you say plus L minus 2, it is 1 time L minus 2. Now take L minus 2 common. When you take L minus 2 common, we get L minus 2 into L plus 1 equal to 0. Now what happened? Either L equal L minus 2 equal to 0 or L plus 1 equal to 0. That is L is equals to 2 or L is equal to minus 1. It has got two values. One is positive. Another is negative. What's the positive value? L equal to 2 is positive. What's the negative value? L equal to minus 1 is negative. Which value will be taken by the number L. L takes only positive value. Why? What is L? Limit of the sequence. Limit of sequence. What's the sequence? The sequence is a1 is root 1, an plus 1 is square root of 2 plus an. That is, each and every term of the sequence is positive. Hence, the limit of the sequence must be positive. Since L being the sequence, limit of the sequence, it must be positive. And hence, L cannot be minus 1. L cannot be minus 1 and L is equals to 2. What is L? L is the positive root of the equation x prime minus x minus 2 equal to 0. Therefore, L equal to 2 is the positive root of the equation x prime minus x minus L equal to 0. That is, the sequence An converges to the positive root of the equation, namely L square x square minus 2 equals to 0.